Hi, this is Kent Hall Jr. in the trophy room of my father, Kent W. Hall Sr., who passed earlier this year. I'm going to give you a quick tour of his trophy room. We'll start with the monkeys, with hear no, see no, speak no, and do no evil, with the college picture that started the idea some 40 years ago. Those monkeys were shot in South Africa in 2009 and 2010 on a hunt with George Gardner. On the top of the front wall, we have the Cape Buffalo skull mounts. The one furthest to the right, I shot in 2002 in Tanzania in the Selu. And I believe the next three, he shot in 3 days in Tanzania again, which the PH at the time said he had never seen before. Then that is maybe a tessabee, I'm not sure. Of course, the eland and I think that's a blue wildebeest. And we have various kudu skull mounts and the eland and a water buck here. And then this is actually a very, very nice bush buck, which I don't know where he shot.
What about the bobcat?
Bobcat was, I was with him. We were in Del Rio, Texas, I believe in 1999. It was actually a double. He got a doe and a bobcat back to back. The elk, New Mexico, nothing special, too special about it. We have the Inyala, which I believe was in Botswana in 2007. There's the mule deer from Old Mexico, I believe in 2008 or 9, on the last day with the guide's gun in the alfalfa field that scored 183 and 3/4. It's probably one G3 away from being a 200-inch mule deer. See the drop time. The other mule deer further up is from New Mexico. I think it was 165, 167. It was supposed to be a special hunt in a new game area that just opened, but they got 12 inches of snow in the first 18 hours, and that was the first mule deer he saw, so he went ahead and shot it. And it turned out to be a good idea because it continued to snow the next 3 days and canceled the hunt. It was supposed to be a 7-day hunt. The water buffalo is from Argentina, I believe, in 2009 or 10. And this hunt actually made Dangerous Game magazine, where he wrote a feature article about the 35 HCR. This is a elk from New Mexico, 2008. I was with him. It was a great hunt. We saw this the second to last day in the afternoon. Weren't able to get on it. Went back early the next morning, and Father actually rested his barrel on barbed wire and shot 7 times before killing it. And it only got hit 1 time, but it was lethal enough. These two whitetail were both, I want to say Brady, Texas at the Ford Ranch. And I believe the javelina was down in Del Rio. The next 4 whitetails were all Ville Platte area, Louisiana. Then the last one on the left was Del Rio. I think it's got 20 scoreable points. Pretty neat deer. Pheasants from Old Mexico. And the red stag is actually a drop and pop hunt somewhere in Texas or Louisiana. This is actually a hartebeest taken in South Africa, but on the ranch, the hartebeest and the bonte buck were crossbreeding. So that's what puts that darker maroon color. Usually the hartebeests are a little more orange. And the government actually seized this trophy for a year to confirm it was indeed a hartebeest and not a bonte buck, because the bonte buck are on the restricted list. Next is just a impala from South Africa. And then the two feature pieces is a lioness from the Sandhurst Ranch.
Go stand next to it so we can get a perspective how big it is. How tall are you, Kent?
I'm 6'6". This lioness was taken in 2009 at the Sandhurst Ranch with a 35 HCR from about 40 yards. These claws are still razor sharp, and I believe it took 5 shots from 35 yards. So he's a little excited. The leopard is from 2003, I believe, in Botswana. It is a record book leopard. It was over 90 pounds, and I forgot what the skull measured, but it was deep in the record book. It was not a treed leopard. They did it with spot and stalk, and I believe dogs. And underneath is a full body impala mount.
And which one was your dad's favorite mount?
The leopard, probably this whole scene, and then the Cape Buffalo. He loved the Cape Buffalo. That Cape Buffalo was taken in 2002 in the Salu, the same hunt that I shot mine.
Well, it's a great trophy room, Kent. Thanks for sharing it with us.
No problem.
Thank you very much.